Hey, welcome back to Test Latino. My name is Rafael, and today I want to share with you my experience using what Tesla calls FSD Beta, the latest and greatest public-facing version of Tesla's autopilot for full self-driving. By the end of this video, you will have a better idea of what it's like to collaborate with Tesla as a public beta tester. Let's check it out. First, what does it really mean to be a public beta tester? Well, throughout the years, Tesla has always had beta testers outside their employee group. What they have done is to give an opportunity to Tesla owners to participate in the beta testing program. These are customers that have expressed interest in helping provide feedback on how the new features perform before those features make it to the public. In other words, Tesla creates a new feature or an update to an existing feature, and before it gets sent to every Tesla owner, it is tested to identify bugs or issues that need to be resolved. Now, let's get one thing straight. Tesla does not really need to use customers in order to validate that a particular software build is ready for public consumption. But having the ability to extend the beta versions to more users allows them to further validate that their internal use case validations actually have merit. You should also know that until October of 2020, Tesla owners that are not Tesla employees participating on the beta testers program have always been under a non-disclosure agreement. If you are part of the Tesla beta testers program, you're usually under an agreement with Tesla that your participation in the program is not to be disclosed to the general public. However, in October of 2020, Tesla reached out to a very limited number of Tesla owners, really about 10 or 12 people in the entire world, that are Tesla owners not employed by the company, and offered them to become a public beta tester, meaning that those few selected people could not only participate as part of the beta testers program, but that can also show the new full self-driving beta release to the general public on social media. I am one of those lucky Tesla owners that was offered a chance to be part of the program. Now, as time went by, a few more public beta testers were added to the public group. Now there's about 50 or so public beta testers, maybe even more. The rumor is that there could be as many as 800 Tesla owners that are not Tesla employees running the latest version of the full self-driving beta release. Many of those people are under a non-disclosure agreement, maybe even about 1,000. But I myself am not actually restricted. I can actually show anyone how the FSD beta software works. But because there are many people that either don't understand what a beta version is, or people that actually try to create negative stories about Tesla because they either have an interest on Tesla to fail, or they make money by creating negative stories that drive traffic to their medium, I don't do interviews with mainstream media. Basically, to avoid or minimize the way some people twist the reality of the current functionality of the software. The reality is that I may never be on the actual latest and greatest build. I could be on a build that is far behind what Tesla's planning on deploying to the public. They may even be giving me a version that is targeting specific issues that need to be resolved. At the same time, who knows? I could actually be running the latest and greatest release. I may never know. But one thing that I can tell you for sure is that the version that I have running in my car is mind-blowing. It's incredible. My car can basically take me from point A to point B with almost no interventions from my side on any given day. Sometimes it seems as if my car is running a different version even without getting a new update. I don't know for sure if Tesla can actually send modifications for the behavior of my car without actually deploying a new build, but sometimes it definitely feels like it. The good thing is that even when the car is about to do something wrong, it really takes me very little effort to ensure that I prevent it from doing anything terrible. just like with the public version of Autopilot. It's as easy as that. As long as I'm paying attention at all times and ready to take control, the car really cannot do anything unless I allow it. But what are the things that the car can do with FSD Beta? The way it works, it's as follows. Let's say that I want to go to a destination. I search for that destination on the onboard navigation application. And once the route is on the screen, as soon as I see the speed and auto steer icons are available, I can actually engage Autopilot. The difference with my Autopilot and that of other non-beta tester owners is that my car can actually navigate through city streets. It reacts to traffic signs, stop signs, and any of the city objects, including traffic, in order to reach my destination. Now, this is very, very important, so pay attention. FSD Beta is not, I repeat, it is not a fully autonomous application. My car still requires a human to be behind the wheel, and I need to be ready to take over at any given time, even more than when I'm manually driving. Why? Well, because the car can do the wrong thing at the worst time possible. So again, because this is not final release or even attempting to be a final release of the fully autonomous capabilities of the software. Every time that I intervene with what the car wants to do by either accelerating or fully deactivating the system by braking or disengaging, Tesla receives that information. They get data that helps them identify what happened when I executed an intervention. This allows them to make adjustments on the decisions the car is making, resulting in improvements with every version they deploy to the group of vehicles that are running FSD Beta. I have demonstrated FSD Beta to many people here on YouTube, on Twitter, and in person. My viewers, friends, family, they all get to see what the car can do and what it cannot do. While most people understand that even when something less than ideal happens, that it may not be a reflection of the current state, and they understand that those are things that they have either already identified or that will be fixed in the future release. But some people may think that the system is useless because it needs to be perfect in order to be used by the general public. I partially agree with that, but mostly I don't. And here's why. At this time, I can confidently say that probably less than 5% of an FSD beta drive encounters problem. As a matter of fact, it is flawless most of the time. But like I said before, the same areas can be driven without any issues many times, and then when I least expect it, there is a problem. It could be because of surrounding traffic, that something changed, or even the weather. But sometimes it just fails to negotiate simple conditions. This is exactly when my interventions really matter. This is what Tesla uses to make the system better. One thing that I can also do to give Tesla even more data to help them identify problems that need to be fixed is taking snapshots. Now, what is a snapshot? Well, my car's interface has several user features that are not found in non-beta Teslas. I have the beta visualizations that show a rough view of what the car can see with its cameras and sensors, but I also have a special icon at the top of the screen that looks like a little video camera. That is the snapshots button. Whenever I see anything interesting that I feel like Tesla should take a look at, I tap on that icon and the car sends a small video that is a couple of minutes long to Tesla. They review it, and they also get all sorts of data with this information, with this snapshot. This helps them identify things that need to be considered. I also send snapshots when I disengage because of something that is critical to the basic functionality of the drive that should have been managed better by the car. Like when it tries to do something terribly wrong. But remember, the car cannot do something completely wrong unless I let it do it because I am always in control. One thing is for sure, I never get complacent when I'm testing FSD Beta. Well, I hope that today I was able to help you better understand what it means to be a beta tester for the public-facing version of the beta. If you want to check some of the videos that I have published while using FSD Beta, you can check out my FSD Beta playlist right here on the channel. I hope you're having a good day wherever you are, and I will catch you on the next one. Hasta luego.